टुडे वी विल सी हाउ टू डू एसी सिमुलेशन ऑफ सोलर सेल्स पी इंजेक्शन डिवाइसेस. बेसिकली एसी सिमुलेशन व्हेन आई से दैट मींस लाइक फ्रीक्वेंसी डिपेंडेंट परफॉर्मेंस एनालिसिस. से फॉर एग्जांपल इफ यू हैव कैपेसिटेंस अ फंक्शन ऑफ अ फ्रीक्वेंसी सो यू हैव वन लाइक कैपेबिलिटी इन दिस कैप्स यू कैन सी हियर CF. सो दिस वन इज CF. So capacitance is a function of frequency. So frequency in the range is given. You can like give a range of frequency. Similarly, you can do also CV, capacitance as a function of voltage. So today we will see those things. So let me get one file. So I will just load one inbuilt file. So in this file, if I go CDT, so CDT is P type and the thickness is they have taken 4. I will take one thickness, 1 micron. And this is defect type donor, so this is not what I want. I want acceptor type defect because it is P type, so acceptor type defect and all those things are correct. And then I will go to CDS. Here they have taken acceptor type, so again this will be donor type, and this is correct. So this is correct. So then okay, now we are done. SNO is okay. This is again donor type, so this is correct. So now in this structure, this is our structure, P and N plus type structure. So what I will do, I will now take say CV value or CF value. I will try to simulate out in light condition. And okay, so let me simulate out CV and CF. So give single shot. So you can see CV and CF is being simulated. So it's done. Now I will go to. So when we have simulated CV and CF, it will always it will give IV also. So IV, even though we have not simulated IV, but because it have scanned from -0.828 in the case of this CV, you can see these values. So it is already giving us IV curve. And now we go to CV. So you can see capacitance as a function of voltage is being simulated. Okay, so we can see that after some 0.6 volt, capacitance is started increasing. Okay, so capacitance behavior of P injection device is being simulated out. Okay, so that's the thing. And then from this CV curve, they have plotted Mott Schottky plot. So 1 by C square versus voltage. Okay, so you can see from this graph, Mott Schottky plot, we can find out the carrier density and like what is the knee voltage or built-in voltage in the device. These things we can simulate out from this curve, this particular curve, Mott Schottky curve. Okay, so these two are like very useful for device analysis, P injection device analysis. Okay, and then we have doping profile, how the doping profile varies near to a depletion region. So this is this region is near to depletion region, so because we have taken 1 micron as a thickness. So you can see from 0.8 to 1 micron, so this is near to the junction. Okay, so near to the junction, how does carrier density is varying, so that is being shown. So you can see within this range, there's a huge like 10 over 3 or 3 time, 3 order of carrier density variation. Okay, so beyond 0.8, so 0 to 0.8 micron, it will be like quasi-neutral, and from 0.8 to 1, this is depletion region. Okay, and this is conductance plot. So how does the conductance with the voltage variation? So this is our this is all about our CV. Now if I go to CF, capacitance versus frequency, so you can see this is somewhat not correct. So like this will not be acceptable in publications, so we need to like see why this kind of behavior is coming. So what we can do in that case, if we are getting this kind of behavior, just increase these values. So you can see this is value is almost same, 8.353 and 8.353. So if we just change this value, we can get a correct order. So let me try it. Y-axis, let me give, so this is 8, so I will give 5 to 10. If I just give 5 to 10, let us see what happens. I think we will get a straight line. So we are getting a straight line kind of behavior. So capacitance is constant without any effect on the frequency. And this is conductance versus frequency, and so most important of them is this Nyquist plot. So the graph between real and imaginary resistance values or reactance values. basically you can say graph between imaginary and real impedance values. Okay, so this is Nyquist plot. Okay, so this is an important one, and it will give lot more information. I will show you how it is useful for us. Okay, and then QE plot we have not simulated out. So then AC plot we can see various type of like current density phenomena, current density like what the whole density variation, current electron density variation, and total current. So those things are being shown here in this graph. Okay, so what I will show here is how this CV and CF become important. So already we know that CV plot and Mott circuit plot is important, and then here our Nyquist plot is important. So how they are going to be important, or this CF plot is important, how they are going to be important, because they give signatures of defect present in a device. So I will give you one simplest example. What I will do, I will go back and I will give resistance value, shunt resistance value I will give. So let me give such shunt resistance value, say 4, 10 to the power 4. So if I give this resistance value, shunt resistance value, and then simulate it out, you will see we will get some signature effect on our Nyquist plot on our other phenomena. So just go to CV plot, you can see there is a variation in Nyquist plot. Okay, so and there is a variation in conductance value. Okay, so those things are visible. If you go to CV plot, so there is not much variation in CV CF. So I have just given one example. So if I just drastically decrease it, say 10 to the 3, if I give it, and then I will just simulate again, we can see out what is happening. So CV, now you can see there is a huge decrement in the Nyquist plot. You can see these values are like hugely decreasing. Okay, similarly CV plot, so you can see here conductance values are changing. If I just simulate it, if I just see it, whether there is any impact on capacitance or not, this is from 8 to 9. So like this value is almost not that much varying, almost remaining constant, because we have taken simple p-n junction only we have taken. So if we have defects, then this behavior, this will also change. So these CV will also give signature effect. Similarly, CF will also give such a signature effect. Already similar to our Nyquist plot variation, these CF also will start giving variations when we have a suitable type of defect. So what one can do is one can plot CF as a function of temperature. So one can vary the temperature from here, just vary the temperature from here, and then plot CV plot, CF plot or CV plot, and then see out for many values of temperature how does the CF plot evolve. So we can see one particular pattern coming out. So if I just show you CDT, what I will do, I will just increase the defect density here, 2 to the power 15 I am taking defect density, and then I am simulating it. Okay, let me simulate. So this is, I will take 5, because okay, so now if we simulate it, let's see what happens if there is any variation in our CF plot. So CF has already changed. Okay, CF plot have already changed. Okay, so now if I do temperature variation, what is the thing coming out? So those things can be simulated out easily, can be simulated out easily, and can be observed easily. So let me give to 11. So these things are like very minute. So we are seeing a straight line only, no? If we zoom it and take down this value. So how to take down this value? Just click on the show, you will get all the data coming out. Okay, so there you can plot, and then we will get this Nyquist plot variation is clearly visible here. Similarly, other variation with different defect density, with different sort of temperature variation or voltage variation or frequency variation. So all those variation can be observed, and perfect type of behavior can be observed. Okay, so let me show you some of the figures for you, and I will just put these figures, so you can see these figures are giving us some glimpse like what AC simulation can do for characterization of our devices. And then this is very much useful for our publication point of view. So because if we just generate this pattern and if we like figure out one particular variation depending upon one particular parameters, is for instance, or say some internal defects or some internal recombination mechanism, then these are like highly publishable. So please go ahead and employ them in your publications, employ them in your work, and utilize these CF and CF, CV and CF capabilities for your research work. So if you have like any queries, the discussion forum is always on. So thank you for listening, and please subscribe to the channel for more such content. Thank you.